All right. Welcome. I haven't prepared any slides. I thought that I could just do a very, very short introduction about Composer, namely just mentioning one important thing. And then you can ask me anything. If you have any issues or if you want to start with Composer, or if you want to convert a not Composer type of free enabled installation to Composer, or if you have issues with upgrading to newer versions of type of free or whatever, ask me anything. So short introduction is basically the website, and I want to highlight this part of the website, namely that Composer should be referenced as dependency manager, not as package manager, as it's often referenced. So what's the difference? Why it is a dependency manager and not a package manager? Actually, Composer deals with packages, so it gets some Lego pieces from anywhere and puts them together. So you could refer to it as package manager, but or it has package manager functionality, but it's important to understand that it's a dependency manager. What does this mean? It means that every package you install with Composer specifies which other packages it needs, right? And not only which other packages it needs, but which other packages in which version it needs. And let's say I have my project, which is also a package. A package has a Composer JSON file, and I specify I need type of free. So let's emulate that. That I say Composer. No, I make a new directory. T3. Okay. All right. And this directory is empty. And to tell Composer that I have a new project and want to start with requiring type of free, I could just say Composer require type of free CMS. No, I just want minimal. And maybe I want a type of free 9.5 minimal type of free installation. That's what I tell Composer. And what happens when I type this? If I open another terminal, oh, wrong color. Default. And make it bigger. What happens then is that Composer creates a Composer JSON file specifying the requirements of this project, which is in this case a minimal installation of type 3 in version 9.5. And this package is registered somewhere, and it specifies it has dependencies to other packages, and these packages have dependencies to other packages. And what Composer does is loading all packages it knows into memory, and trying to resolve all dependencies of all packages that are specified here recursively, and creates a unique state for the current requirements for the current packages that exist. This means it doesn't just load any packages, but creates a state which is reproducible. Right, so if I create, if I say I need type of free minimal 9.5, and you do it as well, you get the exact same result at a given point in time. Because, yeah, a given point in time is important, because currently we have a type of free version 9.5. Who knows, 6, 8. And if tomorrow type 3 version 9.5.9 would be released, then you would get the latest version. But at a current point in time, you get the exact same result. And it's always, yeah, it's always a given state. And I think this one here, yeah, it worked. So you can see the result here, that I get a bunch of type 3 packages, and type 3 requires Symfony, and Symfony requires itself some other stuff like polyfills and so on. And the result is that you have a composer JSON file, which it was created to specify your dependencies of your project. You get a public directory, which is type 3 specific with the system extensions in there, which are also composer packages at the same time. And you have a vendor folder where all the other dependencies are installed into. And very important, you also get a composer lock. And the composer lock removes the time constraint I mentioned before. So at this time, I got type 3 versions, what was it? Oh, it's 11 already. It's 9.5.11. And the composer lock means I locked all the composer packages to the current versions I just installed, right? So in the composer lock, it's machine written. It's not really human readable. But if I look for type 3 CMS core, there was it. You see there, okay, I installed type 3 CMS core and I installed version 9.5.11. This means if I go back here in my directory and remove the public folder and the vendor folder and only leave composer JSON and composer lock in there, if I now type composer install, I get the exact state all the time. So I can share the composer JSON alongside with the composer lock with all my colleagues, with all my friends, with all my open source friends, and they get the exact same state of the exact same versions and packages all the time. That's very important that you get reproducibility with composer. And in practice, of course, it means if you have a composer JSON which describes what you need in your project and put it into version control alongside with a composer lock file, you can deploy or install this project, the code base of this project, anywhere on any servers, on any developer laptops or PCs or whatever. So that's all from me as introduction. Now it's up to you to ask me anything about Composer and or Composer and Type 3. All right, so the question is, where does this directory structure come from and how can I influence this? So one directory structure here you see is the vendor folder, which is the default folder for all regular composer packages. I would recommend to always keep the default, but you can influence how this folder name is called, and that's a composer instruction you can put in your root composer file, which is your main project file. That's this one here. And it can be specified in the config section of your composer's file. And it's called vendor dir. So I can go to my composer here and say config. vendor dir, and call it something else. Packages, like this. And now I could just remove everything again and say that's one important thing I need to mention here. I modified the composer JSON manually. That's something you probably shouldn't do. But I was too lazy to look up the command. You can type a composer command yourself, which is composer config, and then specify that. But if I now say composer install, I probably get a warning. Composer install. No, I don't get a warning. Okay, that's fine. Then just forget about the last sentences. All right, so I say composer install, and then the vendor folder is now called my vendor packages, right? So, so you basically can go to the composer documentation and look what you can specify there in the config section. But there are something special with Type 3. Type 3 was invented before Composer existed, right? So Type 3 had its own directory structure. So you have this Type 3 folder, and in this Type 3 folder, Type 3 expects a sysext folder for all the system extension. And if I would go here and say Composer require my favorite extension example, Georgringer News, then Composer would create a new directory here, or better not in Type 3, but in public, which is called Type 3 conf, and ext and news. So the question now is, or could be, how does Composer know about the Type 3 directory structure? And the answer to that is that Composer itself is extendable. You can create plugins for Composer itself, and plugins could deliver so-called package installers. And these package installers can specify their own directories. And for Type 3, a long time ago, the Type 3 Composer installers package was created. Type 3 packages. Repository, sorry. Packages is something different. There it is. And yeah, it has the package name Type 3 Composer installers, and Type 3 itself requires this package. So it's every time you say I need Type 3, this package is also required. And this package is a Composer plugin, and it knows of packages of certain types. So if I go to Georgringer News and look at its composer JSON, it says, okay, I'm a composer package, my name is this, and my type is, and that's just a reserved string, Type 3 CMS extension. And the composer installers package looks for every package that has this type and always puts it into Type 3 conf ext and then the name of the extension, right? So how does we know the name of the extension? That's also another directive which was invented for Type 3 itself, and it's in the extra section of the extension itself. So it says extra, and there's a subsection in it to collect all the Type 3 related things. And there's the extension key directive. And there is the name news. So I have the package, just to repeat, I have the package Georgringer News.
Does this have to be in the composer JSON of the extension?
Yeah, the question is, does this have to be in the composer.json file of each extension? And the answer is no, it does not have to be. So it's not a strict requirement currently. It could change at some point, but currently it's not. If you don't specify this, then just the vendor, just the vendor name is stripped from the vendor name, and this the last part is used as extension key for type 3, because type 3 doesn't know anything about vendor names and slashes in extension keys. It just knows a single string. One thing that is, from my perspective, a little bit unfortunate, but it was just created this way. If your extension key here, or if your package name here has dashes in it, so for example, my package name is my vendor, and this is my vendor name, and I have my package, then what would you guess would the extension name for type 3 would be if I don't specify it explicitly? So you could expect that the extension key is then my package, but it's not. The extension key actually is my underscore package. So every dash is converted into an underscore.
So it's a recommendation to use this extra. It's not a must have, but it's...
Yeah, so the question is whether this is a recommendation, and I would say yes. It's a recommendation, and all core packages specify that, whether it's necessary or not. But I would say just add it to your composer JSON files of your extensions, just to be explicit how the extension key for type 3 should be. Yeah, so basically the composer installers package, which is a composer plugin, influences where packages of certain types are installed. So if I look into sysext, there's for system extensions, for type 3 core extensions, there's a special type, which is type 3 CMS framework. And you could use this for your own extensions, but it's highly discouraged. I would say it's forbidden to use it. It's reserved. It's not technically forbidden. You could use it, but yeah, just don't do it. So this instruction tells the composer installers, this is a core package, and please don't install it in type 3 conf ext, but in type 3 sysext. But you can instruct the composer installers package to use a different name for public. So this directory structure below public is fixed because type 3 needs it this way. It needs the index.php here and for the front end, and it needs the index.php for the back end in the type 3 subfolder, and the install tool install.php also below this. But you can influence the name of this folder here, which is public. And this is also in the extra section because Composer doesn't know about type 3, as said before. And I think I can just copy it here. No, that's not news. News, yeah. It's also in the section extra, and it's called webdir. And I go to my composer JSON file. At the extra section, I remove all the stuff I don't need. I don't have an extension key. And I say, for example, web. And if I go back here, remove everything again. Oh, okay. My vendor packages. C is just a shorthand for me on my command line. It's an alias for Composer, just in case you wonder. And ins is a shorthand for install. That's a shorthand for Composer. You could type Composer ins. And since there's no other Composer command that starts with ins, it just does it. And now you get the warning which I mentioned before. Because I modified the Composer JSON file manually, Composer warns me, oh, okay, you modified the composer.json file manually. This means it doesn't match the log file I created. So maybe there's something out of sync here. And I guess the result is, no, it worked. But still, if I modify it manually, you could just say composer update log. Just to tell Composer, okay, I hacked here something. I did some modifications, but I know what I've done, so yeah, whatever. So that's how you can influence the directory structure of the type 3 folder. So now the type 3 folder, so basically the folder where you point your web server to, is now called web. And again, I would recommend to go with the defaults, but yeah. If you have another taste, it's totally fine. It's public API, basically. For Composer, it's public API. And for Type 3, it's public. It can be considered as public API as well to change the folder of your web directory, your document root. Yeah, so the question is if you have a web server configuration where the document root is called public, then you don't have to add anything. That is correct, exactly. So that would also be my recommendation. There is some, it's a little bit tricky because this default with public, it was introduced with Type 3 9.5. So it's valid for 9.5 installations and for Type 3 10 installations. But for Type 3 8.7 installations, it's different. And I would recommend to configure this for Type 3 8.7 installations that it's called public. If you still have 8.7 installations, I also have. But for starting with Type 3.9, you don't need anything at all. Remove it. That's basically the most simple composer JSON for your project, which you can have. Yeah, and don't have syntax errors in your composer JSON files. Thank you. Update the log. And my vendor and web. And then you have it. All right. Any further questions? Yep.
Some people might not use the Type 3 minimal installation. For instance, they use they add all the Type 3 packages by itself. What is your personal recommendation? Use a special package or add all the packages you need by yourself to the Composer?
Yeah, so the question is whether I would recommend to use Type 3 minimal or just require all packages individually here. What packages exist? You can find, does anybody know the URL exactly of this composer helper? Type 3 composer helper, I always forget about the URL, composer helper. It's get-type3.org, misc, composer / helper. That's very neat and very, it's very nice. Because it lists all individual packages for any type of Type 3 installation you want to have. So for example, minimal, that's really the bare minimal of Type 3 packages, and that's about? Really? Okay. About? No, that can't. Oh, no. They're grayed out. They're all right. So it's backend, core, XBase, extension manager, file list, fluid, whatever. So what you could do instead of requiring Type 3 minimal is copying this command here. and then you would have all the individual packages, and then you could remove type 3 minimal. The only reason type 3 minimal was created is to help you to avoid errors. So for example, if I use individual packages and I forgot about, for example, backend, then pretty much everything is broken. Or if you forgot install, not everything is broken, but some things are broken. But still, Composer won't complain because these individual packages don't require each other itself. So for Composer, everything is fine, but for Type 3, not everything is fine. So my recommendation would be, my recommendation would be for the really bare minimum of packages, use minimal, because then you're sure you get the bare minimum Type 3 in this version currently needs. And this might change. It actually changed from 8 to 9 because salted passwords was removed. So if you, for example, in 8 forgot about salted passwords, then you probably couldn't log in anymore in the backend. So my recommendation for the base packages, use minimal. And for all other packages, optional packages, like if I go back to the Composer helper, like about or admin panel or backend log or stuff like that, use the individual packages you need. So this would be my recommendation. If I go back, minimal, and I would probably go this way, type of 3, CMS core 9.5. All right, so that's what I would do. I would require minimal, which guarantees that I have the minimum required of type 3 packages, all of them. And I specify for the project, for my project will need type 3 9.5. And as a representation for that, I specify, okay, type 3 CMS core, I need in 9.5. What happens then is basically the same. Update log. And then I say, okay, that's really the bare minimum, but in my project I need, for example, a scheduler or something like this. Then I say Composer require type 3 CMS scheduler, and this would also be my recommendation to say scheduler star. Why is this my recommendation? It is my recommendation because each package of each type of 3 package requires the type of 3 CMS core package in the exact version. What does this mean? I go back here. Can you rephrase the question for me, please?
What's the difference between adding a star in the end of your Composer command and just leave it without?
Oh, here?
Oh,
so the question is, what's the difference between specifying a version number here, or in this case, what's the difference between, this is a version number for Composer. Star is a version number, which means, or version range, more specifically, it's a version range, which means give me the package type of 3 CMS scheduler in any version that matches any other dependencies in my project. But if I don't specify this, I can do this. And this will fail. Scheduler is installed now, but if I say BE log, this will now fail. Because what Composer does with a composer require and a package name, and you don't specify a version number, it looks at the package registry, which is packagist, looks up the latest version of this package, writes this latest version in the composer JSON file, and then tries a composer install. And the latest version of type 3 CMSB log is 10.1. And 10.1 doesn't work well with type 3 core 9.5. Actually, it doesn't work at all. because each package, if I go back here, let's say scheduler, composer, where is it here? Maybe take a released version, releases. Where's the 10? Here's 10. And browse files, type 3, scheduler, composer JSON. So that's version 10.1.0 of the scheduler package. And 10.1.0 of the scheduler package requires exactly 10.1.0 of the core package. We were strict, very, very, very strict here, because type 3, the versions of each package or the code base still depend on each other. So we weren't confident saying, okay, yeah, it might be okay to install scheduler in 10.1.0 and core in 10.1.1, because it could be that changes were made that are conflicting each other. So we are currently, and I think for a bit longer, we are very strict, so that any additional package except core require the exact core version. So you don't get scheduler in 9.5.1 and the core in 9.5.11. This won't work on composer level, really. And this this is my recommendation. This I take to my advantage. I say I have type 3 minimal in any version, just to make sure I get any package. And I specify only one package, which is core, in the exact version I need for the project. In this case, it's the caret 8.5, which means give me any version higher or equal 9.5, but lower than 10. That's the caret character. And that's fine for my project, because I want bug fix versions. In theory, I would get minor version updates as well, but in the type 3 community, we won't release minor updates after the LTS, so there won't be a 9.6. So we can just go with the default notation for Composer, which we say, okay, in this project we need 9.5. And if a new version is released, that's the benefit of this notation. If a new version is released, I could, if I want to upgrade this project to, that's mainly the point, if I want to update this project here, I can just say Composer require, I want to go with 10.1, type of 3 CMS core, and I only need to specify one package here and not any package, because I specified the version numbers here as well. So that's one nice neat trick. Yeah, so the question is, basically, I extended a little bit, what other notations are possible? So the caret notation means anything that I specified after the caret is the minimum version. So if I specify three version numbers here, for example, 9.5.3, it would mean the 9.5.3 is the minimal version, and the maximum version is anything which is not 10. So it doesn't allow me an update, a major upgrade, basically, which is considered breaking from a semantic versioning standpoint. But you could safely also specify, this is another notation which you mentioned, you can also safely specify this, 9.5.star, which means give me any 9.5 and a star. Yeah.
This means the star is not necessary. You can put any number and will always take the latest.
Yeah. Okay. This is just an alternative notation. And there's a last notation, which is more, it was introduced before the caret notation, but it's more or less out of date. It's not really deprecated, but this is if you specify the tilde character, then, and you specify three points in your version number, then it's basically the same as the caret. And the complicated thing about this is, if you specify only two, then it means something different, because then it allows the minor version. So, yeah, I won't necessarily recommend this. I would recommend the caret, and then the minimum version number. Or if you want to be very explicit, it's of course also fine to just say higher or equal 9.5.3 and whatever it, 10, something like this. That's also fine. It's just a matter of taste. Yeah.
There's a really nice website for it called semver.mwl.be.
Can you say again?
See what you get.
Semver.
Semver.mwl.
MW. Yeah. Okay.
Belgium.
Okay, so there's a website.
So you can just put in your NC and then the constraint you are using, and you will see what you get.
Ah, that's nice. So you can say here type of 3 CMS core, and you specify the version constraint 9.5. Search. Okay. 9.5. And then you see which version matches for this constraint. Yeah, that's very nice. Good, very good. Very good hint. And if I say, no, that doesn't work. Maybe take 10, 0, it gets these. And if I say tilde, oh, there's. Oh, yeah, with tilde I get the one as well, with caret also, yeah. Yeah, that's nice. Okay, further questions? Yeah?
Is it possible, before Composer you had this install tool, and anytime there was some updates for extensions, you had this little icon which showed you, okay, you should update the extension, but you don't have it anymore when you use Composer.
Yeah, so the question is there any possibility when you have a Composer installation to be informed about updates of, let's say, type 3 extensions or maybe any other package? I will emulate this now to show it to you. I say Composer require type 3 CMS, no, type 3 CMS core. And as a version constraint, I say 5.0. I can, as version constraint, I also can specify exact version numbers. So in this case, it probably will fail. And I can tell you how you can fix this. So now I have one of the famous Composer error messages. What does it tell me? It says, okay, I tried to resolve the dependencies in your project from the log file I found here. and it says, you specified you want Type3 CMS core in 9.5.0, but I have the package Type3 CMS backend in the version 9.5.11, which requires Type3.cms.core in 9.5.11. So this doesn't work. But what I could do, hopefully, update with, I can specify, I want this version, but please, Composer, allow all dependencies to be updated as well. Hopefully this works. Nope, doesn't work. Yeah, and I can tell you why it doesn't work, because Type3 CMS core doesn't depend on Type3 CMS backend. It's the other way around. So there's another trick. I tell Composer to not update the project, but just specify this this dependency in my composer JSON file. So basically, this command just updates the composer JSON. And now it says this. And now I can tell Composer, OK, Composer, update Type3. And so I don't know if you know this, but you can specify wildcards in the update commands as well. So I can say, Composer, I have a new composer JSON file here for you. Update all packages which start with the vendor name Type3 / and then anything. This should work now. No. Ah, okay. Now with all dependencies. This should work now. So now I get Type3 9.5.0 installation. And now I can come back to the question, how do I know if I have installed this a few months ago? How do I know that there are newer packages which I can install in this project? I haven't installed Type3.9.5.0, obviously. Can someone sing a waiting theme song? Dee, 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 dee. Ah, okay. All right. So, and the command for this, the composer command is show outdated. No. No, it's not show, sorry. It's just outdated, sorry. And then you get a nice list of all outdated packages. In this case, it's mostly the Type3 packages. The only downside, I'm not sure if somebody of you knows how to fix this. In this case, I also get, the newest Type3 version here. I'm not sure how to fix the outdated command, that it's only shows you minor. That's a really good.
But what about the extensions which exists? For example, TLR Monitor or
But I think there's an even simpler solution. So you can, you do have a scheduler task job to fetch the extension information in your Type3 installation. And you do get the update information in your extension manager list, even if you do not
even if you could not update, but you see the icons.
Yeah, so the other suggestion would be to just use the extension manager functionality and use a scheduler task to update the extension manager information. This would work as well for all packages that are available in the TER, but it won't work for extensions that are directly installed from GitHub. And I think it also doesn't work for Type3. I'm not sure if there's an update function, notification update thing for Type3 itself. Another possibility would be is not Composer outdated, but Composer update Type3 CMS, no, Type3, let's say, no, or maybe something like this, CMS star, this works as well, so you can just say this, and then with all dependencies, and you can specify dry run. And then Composer doesn't do anything, but just tries or tells you which packages it would update. So this would be another nothing. Ah, yeah, okay, nothing, of course, because I have the version constraint still here. If I go back, say this. Yeah, so it would tell you that it would update Type3 CMS core to newer versions. So this is an alternative. And I'm pretty sure that the outdated command, that you can specify more stuff in there. So I, that's not the Composer. Documentation. Yeah, command line interface, outdated. Yeah, you can specify minor only. Outdated, minor only. Yeah, and then you see it. And the nice thing about this as well is that if I remember correctly, no, that's like this. No, it's not like this. Just try it again. I think it has a return code only. Yeah, it's strict. Okay. If you specify strict, then the return code won't be zero, which means it's an error for Linux. So you could automate this in your whatever environment and run this Composer outdated command regularly. And if it returns an error code, then you could send out mails or something like this. So that's how you could do it. Oh, it's already time's off. All right. So thank you very much. If you still have any questions, I'm around here till tomorrow noon. So yeah, ask me anything, anytime. Thanks.